say it.
Let's get together and feel alright.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Let them all pass all their dirty remarks.
One love.
There is one question I'd really love to ask.
One heart.
Is there a place for the hopeless sinners who has hurt all mankind? Just a savior's own belief.
One love.
I can feel your head. like a ray of sun, burning through my darkest night. You're the only one that I want, think I'm addicted to your light. I swore I'd never fall again, but this don't even feel like falling. Gravity can't begin to pull me back to the ground again. It's like I've been awakened.
Sorrow fills our heart during this sad moment. A sad moment that is deep and personal. Tony has silently closed the door of life and departs from us. Our life will be empty in the areas that we want to practice. That is why we are gathered here today to say goodbye to him. Albert Einstein once said, "The value of a good man shall be seen in what he gave, and not in what he is able to receive." Tony was a man who gave his all when it comes to work and his family. He ensured that whatever he did was sufficient for his loved ones. He lived a life which required notice, one that demonstrated brilliance, love and kindness, a life that inspired and motivated others around him. He lived a life that was humble, which ensures that the life of our others were brightened. He left many great memories for me and many others. I know that I will always miss him. He was my best friend. Tony lived a life that pointed others to heaven, the place where he is now reside. He honored and cherished him for who he was. His memories, which bittersweet, we will hold in our hearts and minds until we meet again. Many of us here were loved by you, by and your grace. It was said that grief is simple, when a press love. The moral idea is that grief is something we should avoid or try to overcome, but something we should embrace. If grief really is just a reflection of love, we feel that the person we love, then we should hope to always feel some measures of grief for our deepest loved ones. I think there is some wisdom there and perhaps some comfort for those of us who are still grieving Tony's lost today. Indeed, Tony was the happy warrior, the one that the poet Woodward spoke of when he wrote, "As tempted more able to endure, as more exposed to suffering and distress. Things are almost a life of tending." Through his own suffering, Tony became more alive to plight and the suffering of others, including my mother, who is sick, my plight, and my granddaughters. My dearest Tony, you made me laugh and was always there to help me figure things out. You listened to my problems and helped me solve them. I say thank you for all the help and support you provided to me and my entire family whilst you were alive. You played a role as a father in my children's life. You supported me and all your loved ones, your wife, your brothers and sisters, your friends, and everyone that was important to you. Challenges. You are in heaven now, but I know from this, saying, forge ahead, make the best of life, and I will see you soon. In closing, I want to say, the journey does not end here. Death is just another path, one that we all must take. The bravery and beauty of the world go back. And the third, they turn into silver glass, and then you see it. My God, may God welcome you in his heavenly kingdom. Continue to rest in peace till we meet again. Goodbye and goodbye, my best friend. May God bless you. Fly high with the angel. Also, tomorrow is gonna be your 60th birthday. It's gonna be a tough day for us all here. A birthday that will be spent without you. A birthday that we want always celebrate together. But I know you're gonna have a great day with your mom, dad, and most of all, the Most High. So, love is coming your way from your wife, your best friend here, your children, your grandkids, your brothers and sisters, and everybody else. Tony, to some of you will never forget. To others, you judge the past. And those who love and lost, you, the memory will always last. It takes a second to say hello and forever to say goodbye. Continue to rest in peace till you meet again.
I want to thank everybody for coming. I really appreciate that. The people of Sukukri have been phenomenal for me, as well as all around the island. I couldn't do this without your support. Tony and I were together 25 years. That's a long time, quarter century. Glad I was there now, but those two of you, I didn't really curse today.
My heart is going out to Tony, and I want you to know he loved his family. His children were absolutely everything to him, and we spent as much time as we possibly could with them when we were in Canada. Our life took a different path when we came down to St. Lucia to make a new life. Our children were old enough by then to leave behind. So we proceeded to settle, to make new friends, and to embrace our family. I think I ran out of words. I really think I did. Yeah, I can't. I'm sorry, everybody.
Yeah, good afternoon to all. It's not much I have to say. I'll just make it brief. Because I know there is orders to come to speak.
On behalf of my brother Tony, he was a brother that I had really, really loved. I was always together with him during all his suffering. I see what was going with him. He always used to tell me. He always used to tell me, brother, look what they done to me. And they left me to die. Until the last time of his suffering, I was there. But so be it that his suffering has ended. It's a great loss to the family. But as you leave, one day you have to go. And you can never return when you go. This is life. This is an acceptance in life. Whatever the case may be, you live 100 years, one day you have to say goodbye, never to you return again. I'm not the only brother. I am the sixth in the brothers. None of his children is there to see exactly what is going on. Right now, Luke Tony is sitting right there in the jade. But that's life. There's nothing we can do. If he had to go to the ground, that's where he had to go. But he asked to put him this way. He just didn't go into this. He asked to be there. And we all accept it. The brothers, the sisters, part of the family. That was his wish. So we gave him his wish. And I hope all the other family member, friends, relatives, I just hope that they agree with the fact that he asked to be so. He asked to spread the ash in the sea. That's what he asked. And that's what we're going to give to him. He was a beloved brother. No doubt about it. I was so close to him. I was the only brother he used to see partly every week. He used to speak to the other brothers, but I was with him every week. Since before he fell sick, I was with him all the time. Yeah, I'm going to miss him. Yeah, I'm going to miss him. And I know that we all gonna miss him. It's a true fact. He left a grieving wife behind. He left his kids behind. But that's just life. It's just life. I haven't got much to say because I'm not the priest. The priest is coming after I leave. The priest is coming. I just had a brief comment to make, not that long. And I just thanking everybody that's sitting there today, supporting Tony, supporting the wife, Aldona. She's not alone. We are all there to support her. She's not alone. We'll never turn up our back. Yeah, she's part of us. And it will remain this way until time to time. I thank everybody for listening. And may Tony rest in peace.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Praise be to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, and the Lord of all consolation. He comforts us in all our afflictions, and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bless the remains of Anthony Palix with holy water that recalls his baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us were baptized into Christ Jesus, were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection.
Thank you.
what he has to do until he has all his enemies under his feet. And the last of the enemies to him is sure to be dead. For everything is to be put under his feet. Though when it is said that everything is subject to him, he still cannot include the one who subjected everything to him. And when everything is subjected to him, then the Son of the Devil will be subjected to his still to the one who subjected all things to him, so that one may be born in all. This is the word of God.
God. And so utterly is God.
No one can replace him in terms of who he was. People can replace him in what he did, in his work, but nobody can replace him in terms of who he was while he walked this earth. And so I hope that this funeral liturgy will bring you some prayerful closure. And, you know, alongside your witness to this, that take comfort that Anthony prepared himself. I had the opportunity to visit him in the home on two occasions, and we spoke, and he was preparing himself. Although I was not sure of the medical diagnosis, I did not ask. I'm very prudent when it comes to that. Even when I visit people, I don't ask questions unless they would volunteer information. But anyhow, he was ready and preparing himself to meet the Lord. I picked up as a terminal illness, I wasn't sure what it was, and as I said, I did not ask. But we spoke about him being involved in Pastor Jean as an altar server. He remembered the names of different parish priests, you know. So there was that memory there, that mystery there, that he was able to connect with where the church is concerned. And so take comfort and hope that he prepared himself to meet the Lord. And that, as I said, this liturgy, this funeral liturgy, will bring some prayerful closure, some comfort and consolation by the prayers, the hymns, the gestures, including the signing of the registers. And all what we do here today will bring some prayerful closure and comfort in the name of Jesus, who himself comforted Mary and Martha at the death of their brother Lazarus, whom we read about in the scriptures. That's my hope and my prayer for you. May the God who is the God of all consolation, may he strengthen you in all your endeavors, and may our Lord bring peace and comfort to you, Alonso, and the family, and the children, and may you be able to persevere even as you lay the remains of Anthony to rest today. May God bless you.
Thank you. our beloved brother, Anthony Harris, who have departed into his soul. We humbly pray for your mercy that he also will enter into your kingdom. Pray to the Lord.
Of your son in his bodily pain. Reward him with patience and forbearance and grant him the fullness of God's victory in eternal life. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for correction and join in singing your pilgrim song.
May our farewell express our affection for him our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again with the love of Christ, which conquers all things and destroys even death itself. Your response is seek his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Thank you.
take the remains of our brother Anthony to its final resting place. Again, we offer condolences to the families and honor my apologies for, I don't know why I would have said in there, keep saying our daughter. And she told me how to pronounce her name. A donor, so my apology. I got it right this time. I don't know why you could send in there. But my apologies. Condolences again, and God speaks to you with me. Over to you, Mrs.
challenge in there.